New findings. Summary. When you moved to Tcsm, you were 5. You moved right next to the Sawyer house. You become good friends with Bubba. Your dad wasn't a nice man either. You were always at their house as your dad hurt you and your mom. But as you grew older, you fell in love with Bubba. Notes. Welcome to New Findings. There's a smut warning, but that's going to be further on in the story. Enjoy. Chapter 1. Your dad wasn't a nice man. He used to hurt your mom and only hurt you when he was drunk and your mother was out. But when you moved to Tcsm, you found a safe space. The Sawyer house. You and Bubba were the same age when you moved to Tcsm. And Sawyer, like a second mother to you. Nubbins was like an older brother to you. But today was definitely not a normal day. Today was your birthday. You were 15. But like usual, you woke up to your dad screaming at your mother for God knows what. You never liked your birthdays. They always ended badly. So you got out of bed and quietly walked into the bathroom. You did your business and walked out. Got dressed and went downstairs. By this point, the argument died down and it was quiet. You walked into the kitchen and saw your mom making breakfast and your dad in the living room reading the paper. Morning, mom, you said when you walked into the kitchen and kissed your mom's cheek before sitting at the table. Morning, sweetheart. Happy birthday, darling. We're going to go to the Sawyer house and spend the day with them. Does that sound okay? She sounded cheerful, like nothing happened. That's what you hated about your mother. No matter what happened, your mom was always happy. Yeah, that sounds fine, I guess, you said while eating your eggs and bacon. She looked at you sadly and then walked to the counter and got your present. Happy birthday, sweetheart. I love you, she said sweetly. She never failed to get you something for your birthday. Thanks, mom, you smiled gratefully. You opened it and looked inside. A guitar you wanted since you were little. Oh my God, thanks, mom. You know, I always wanted one. By this point, your dad had walked in and sat down. Don't thank her. She used my money to get that. You should thank me, not her, he shouted at you. You stared at him blankly. You decided enough was enough. Just shut up, dad. No one asked you. You are so horrible to mother. It's getting so annoying. You don't understand how upset it makes me trying hard to be okay for her, you shouted at him. How dare you speak to me like that, he shouted. By this point, you were halfway across the kitchen. You had enough and decided to go to the Sawyer house. You walked upstairs, grabbed a bag, and started dumping clothes and things into your bag. Your mom ushered into your room and was begging you to stay. Sweetheart, please don't leave. Where are you going? Where are you gonna go? She said sadly. She was sobbing, but you didn't care. You were too angry. I don't know, mom. Away from that bastard that abuses you 24/7. You zipped up your bag and took your guitar with you. You walked to the other door and your mom came too and said, I'll be there soon. Give me a little while. She whispered at you before you walked out. As soon as you walked up the Sawyer driveway, you saw Bubba. All of a sudden, it was hard to breathe. You got to your knees. You dropped everything. Bubba saw and squealed like a pig. He ran over and got you and your stuff and took you inside. When he got inside and saw the state you were in, oh, darling, it's okay. Your mother called saying you were coming. It's okay, sweetheart. Deep breaths for me, she said so sweetly. By this point, Nubbins and Drayden were all in the kitchen wondering what was going on. What in the devil's name is going on in... Oh. Drayden came in curious and a bit annoyed until he saw you hyperventilating and crying hard. Bubba was at your side hugging you and holding your hand. He did it again. I got so angry at him, shouted, and mom got scared. I didn't know what to do, so I left. You sobbed and sighed and hugged you. That bastard. I'm gonna kill him. Drayden mumbled under his breath. Drayden! And whispered at him. He's a bastard. Hey, why can't we go visit him? Nubbins said. And shot him a look and continued comforting her for a few hours later. You were feeling so much better and was hugging Bubba on the sofa in the living room. He was telling you all about his pet chicken he caught. Bubba? You said as you nuzzled into his chest. Bubba quietly squealed to let you know he was listening. Do you ever get so angry you can't breathe? You whispered. Not wanting Anne or anyone else to hear, Bubba babbled something and nodded as he looked down at you and kissed the crown of your head. You looked up and smiled at him. There was a knock at the door. You sniffled. You stiffened and hugged Bubba harder. Anne opened the door and found your dad standing there, angry as ever. Where is she? I know she's here, he shouted at Anne. He looked over her shoulder and saw you and Bubba hugging. Hey, pigman, let go of my daughter right now, he shouted at Bubba. What are you gonna do, pig? Ah, fuck! Your dad shouted when Bubba kicked him right in the balls. Anne laughed lightly and smiled at your dad. That's where she is. If you want her, too bad. She's not feeling well and doesn't want to come home. She smiles at your dad and closes the door. As that happened, Bubba walked over to you and pulled you closer to him on the couch. Anne came over and kissed you and Bubba's head. Do you want a hot chocolate, dear? She asked you and Bubba. Yes, please, you whispered into Bubba's chest. Bubba also squealed softly and nodded. Anne smiled and walked off to make them for you.